You got honorary profession.
I love to say I'm a businessman. Okay, so I was very tough, you know, the businessman when it comes to the academician.
Honorary.
So first of all, thank you very much again. I hope that please try to keep note. I will request everyone, are you ready? Please keep note. If you have the smartphone, keeping smartphone. If you have the blank paper, please put your note in the blank paper so that we can interact. I hope that in whole life you will get lot of time. But please try to use this time very precisely. If you can learn something, and if you can unlearn something, you need to unlearn something. If you just always follow the same trends, if you don't like to unlearn, then you cannot create yourself successful. So I will give you a presentation on the basis of some of my business activities. But at the same time, I hope that considering my business experience, please note it down. You can ask me some questions. Because again, my intention that you are coming here to become an entrepreneur. If my presentation or my discussion is giving you some confidence to become an entrepreneur, that could be my success and of course your success too. So first of all, I should say that, look, I am an entrepreneur and I know the interest and definitely I know the secrecy of to be a successful entrepreneur. But the thing is that if you prepare yourself mentally that yes, I will be an entrepreneur, I will be an entrepreneur, I'm sure that is enough. First you need to mindset that you like to become an entrepreneur. So let's start with some success and failure stories. And you know, a lot of cases everybody when we become very successful, like Bill Gates, like Mark Zuckerberg, Steve Jobs, whatever we are saying, everyone has a lot of background. First they become failure. If you go through all of their background, you'll find that majority cases they become failure first. So we must think that if you like to start anything, we mentally need to prepare ourselves. There is a lot of failure should come in. If there is no failure, you will not find any success. So first of all, I just need all of your attention. You need to think yourself that, okay, I will start. I will do my business. I will run my own way. It doesn't matter I become failure. If your success is very good. But keep in mind, in all of your business step, sometimes you become failure. But that failure is really gives you extra mileage, extra opportunity to make you successful. And I myself, when started my business, whatever business idea I made up my mind to start it, I cannot do it. I changed because I failed. After 6 months, after a few months, I understood that whatever planning I only started to my business, I cannot make my goal perfect. So then what I did it, I selected, okay, as a computer business, because luckily in my honors there was a computer science for 100 mark. Because in that time in 19 I took admission in university in 1983. In that time computers, there was no computer science. So what happened, luckily in my department statistics there was a few mark, 100 mark for computer science, and I got a good mark. So that gave me the confidence, okay, I can start my business as first business I failed. So I can start as a computer business because this was my confidence and I have the background and I have some knowledge, so I can start it. So what happened? If I did not fail first time, I cannot choose the second one. But you see, 90% cases, entrepreneur think, oh, I started my business, I become failure, so I am now asking job. I don't like to become an entrepreneur. Please think yourself, you are a people created by Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you as a perfect man. You have everything. You have knowledge, you have eye, you have good brain, your family is already gave you good opportunity to study. and you have the ability to join in this conference. That's the opportunity. You see, lot of thousand, million students in your country, they are not able to join this conference or this our program. So it's an opportunity for you. You can consider it. It's a strength. It's a marvelous opportunity. But now it is depends on you, how you like to utilize this opportunity. If you think that, no, I feel sleepy, I'm not getting encouraged, I'm not getting good point, oh, if I go to the bed, I just stay few hours, then you cannot become a good entrepreneur. As a good entrepreneur, you must prepare yourself. You don't know when opportunity will be coming. So, as a failure, you need to be prepared yourself. Any time opportunity can come to you. But if you need to be wake up, you need to think positively, you need to prepare yourself every time, you need to write it down, what knowledge you already earned and learned. You need to be fighting every time, because if you can prepare yourself properly, maybe after a few hours, you can find out a good opportunity is waiting for you. As I told, because my background, I become failure. You see, when I made a lot of good business, suddenly I lost all of my money. I lost all of my money, so I thought that I'm ruined. I don't have money. Nobody can help me. But suddenly I just thought myself, what I lose? Money. What is this? It's a paper. What I earn? Knowledge. What I earn? Networking. What I earn? Experience. What I learn? Reputation. What I earn? Branding. What I earn? Trust of the people. So what I lose? Paper. It's not money. It's a paper. So then I thought, okay, Allah gave me the lot of opportunity and experience. Let's try to find out the next opportunity. And if I did not lose all money, maybe I cannot come to this position. Because I did not become frustrated. I thought it's an opportunity for me. I just went to my lot of my friends, lot of my supplier. I tell them, look, I lost all of my money. Can you trust me? Can you believe me to give me the credit facility? But it's an opportunity for me. I found that a lot of my friends give me the credit facility, they gave me the money. So what happened? If I did not become failure, if I did not become loser, I cannot maybe come into this position. So that's why you always keep in mind, if you see failure, if you insult, if you see that a lot of the problem is coming, please don't stop. Keep trust on Allah. Because Allah created all of you. And Allah is already taking the responsibility. Three things, right? One is, your living is not controlled by anyone. It's only Allah. You'll die. It only knows Allah. Nobody knows. You have any watch? You have any control of your body? Can you just switch on anything and you can know how long you will be survived? You cannot. So that means, how long you will be alive in this world? It is only known by Allah. And then your rizq. Whatever food few minutes back you took, I think just yesterday or few hours back, you do not know what food will be coming in front of you. So that means rizq, that food is also controlled by Allah. So what you are doing, the living, die and food, these three things is controlled by Allah. So if you move properly to become a good entrepreneur, if your intention to become a good entrepreneur, if you honestly move to become an entrepreneur, I'm sure that God always stands beside you. Because do you think God has any limitation? God has plenty of resources. So it depends up to you, how you like to fight, how you like to convince your God. If you cannot convince Allah, how can you think that Allah will give you more? If you think I feel sleepy, no, this session is not encourage me. Rather, if I go with my friend, chatting, gossiping, hanging, I can enjoy a few hours. See, that means you are not able to change yourself. You do not think yourself to change. Why God will give you the benefit? Why God will change you, right? So it is you. You should decide it that, okay, I will not go to the any chatting or anything, any amusement, rather I like to change my life. Your intention should be to change yourself with your own idea, own spirit. So now I'm just giving you one video, learn from a failure. You see this video.
points. We just released our finest creation, the Macintosh, a year earlier, and I just turned 30. And then I got fired. As Apple grew, we hired someone who I thought was very talented to run the company with me. And for the first year or so, things went well. But then our visions of the future began to diverge, and eventually we had a falling out. And so at 30, I was out, and very publicly out. What had been the focus of my entire adult life was gone, and it was devastating. I didn't see it then, but it turned out that getting fired from Apple was the best thing that could have ever happened to me. The heaviness of being successful was replaced by the lightness of being a beginner again, less sure about it. It freed me to enter one of the most creative periods of my life. During the next 5 years, I started a company named Next, another company named Pixar, and fell in love with an amazing woman who would become my wife. In a remarkable turn of events, Apple bought Next, and I returned to Apple, and the technology we developed at Next is at the heart of Apple's current renaissance. You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust that something, your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever, because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path, and that will make all the difference. Sometimes life's going to hit you in the head with a brick. Don't lose faith. I'm convinced that the only thing that kept me going was that I loved what I did. You've got to find what you love, and that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking, and don't settle. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. And like any great relationship, it just gets better and better as the years roll on. So keep looking, don't settle. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to do.
Excellent.
Okay, so what Steve Jobs mentioned? See, a few seconds back, I told you our life is limited. He also mentioned that our life is limited.
Don't waste it.
So please don't waste your time. And don't waste to other people's time also. And he also mentioned don't do noise when other people are sleeping. Try to utilize your time. You see, he was a failure. He was sacked from Apple due to his performance. But when he was sacked, he did not lose his spirit. You saw in his video, he did not lose his spirit. He already proved his efficiency in other company. And he already tried to find out to make himself one of the good professional. And once he became a very good professional, then again Apple invited him to join in Apple. And later on, he became the CEO. And you know that now Apple and Steve Jobs is almost considered the same. So that's why if you think that you are failure, it does not mean as an entrepreneur, you never think that you become failure. Rather, you must think that, okay, whenever I'm becoming a failure, it's a success. It's an opportunity for me. So as I mentioned a few minutes back, that look, I started my company in 1990. I find a lot of problem. You see what problem I'm finding. So this 1990, I established my company in Daffodil Computers. Once I completed my just Viva board from the university, after my master's, I just started without getting my result, I started my business. You see, a lot of cases, you student will think, okay, I have enough time. How long you will alive? You don't know. So how can you think that I have enough time? You see, Warren Buffett was asked a lot by interview. Why he started his business while his age was 14. But if anyone is asking, did you feel any sorrowness or you have any regret for any of your job, then he always tell that, yes, I have one regret that why I am not starting my business while my age was 8. While I started while my age was 14. So that's why please keep in mind, 99% cases our students think that I have plenty of time. No, you don't have plenty of time. How can you know that you have plenty of time? Because you don't have your control on your body. You do not have control on your lifetime. So you should think this is the best day today. Today is your best day. Today you try to learn, earn maximum as much as you can. That is your opportunity. So as I told in 1990 when I started, I faced a lot of problems. But you see, in 1990, when I started my company, that company's 2001 became the public first IT public listed company. So, but I never think that my company will be the one of the public listed company in the country. And maybe some of you, those who are acquainted with the share market, you know my company's share market is also very good. So that's why I should say that the think positively. You see, I faced a lot of problems, but I was determined to reach in my destination, and that's why it reaches me in the right destination. So what happened in 1991, I started computer to selling computer accessory, and also I'm working as a desktop publisher. You know the Compose right now, there is a lot of Compose is going on. So I, in that time, you know, the computer Compose was a very unique opportunity, because there in that time 99.9% is controlled by the typewriter machine. So I started computer selling accessories and also as a desktop publisher. But what happened? After a few months, after a few days, I understood it's a huge competition. I'm not getting profit. Because a lot of people started in the street side, they also started to computer composing. So should I think that I'm failure? Should I think, oh, I cannot do business, okay, I'm sorry, I tried my best level, but I cannot make profit? No. I think that what should be my alternate choice? Should I fight with them? If I fought with them, then today maybe I cannot sustain. So it was, in one sense, it was a failure of mine. I cannot do well. So what I did? I escaped from that business. No, I cannot do this business. So that is what I started. I started in 1992 to import various computer parts and computer. So what happened? In 1992, I went to Singapore. I went to Singapore, and from Singapore, I buy various computer parts. I imported and assemble and bring Bangladesh. So what happened? I'm not seeing more competition. But again, in 1993, I found that computer accessory is also very competitive, because a lot of people are also importing. So then I thought that no, I should skip up my business style. I started to assembling computer. So I started first computer PC assembling, and it was very popular in that time in Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, a lot of the people coming to my computer company, and they are already buying computer, and the profit margin was very good. So always I am looking the new opportunity. You see, always I am looking the new opportunity. So you see, now if you are sitting here, as a human being, you can feel sleepy. Because after lunch, maybe you can feel sleepy. If you are an entrepreneur, sleep will not hit to you. Are you agree with me?
Yes.
Yeah. If you are an entrepreneur, this sleep will not hit to you. If you really like, try to learn. What happened? If you sleep will be coming, you will change your seat, you can stand up, you can try to do some internal movement so that the sleep cannot hit you. But if you think, okay, what I can do after lunch, I feel sleepy. So that means you are a failure. You cannot make yourself as an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur needs to be wake up. Entrepreneur needs to find that what opportunity is coming. Because if you feel sleepy, if you become failure, why I'm telling sleepy? The same thing if you go to the business. It can be sleepy. You see, I found every time competition. Every time I found, I cannot. So what I did? I changed my business style. I changed the new opportunity. I tried to adopt the new idea. So what happened? 1994 again, I understood, because the computer assembling is also started by a lot of the young people. They follow me, they follow my company, they also started the computer assembling. So should I fight with them again? No. I thought I should change my track. I'm now feeling like after lunch I am also feeling sleepy. So I should change my style. I should go to the corporate and government supply.
because in that time there is a lot of tender is going on. Government office is going to computerize. They also floated the tender. So I participated in a lot of the government tender and a lot of government solution, and I supply this IT product to the government. Because usually what happened, government supply, they need some experienced company. They need someone that who is financially solvent. So what happened, between this time, I saw my company with the financial ability. So I participated in government tender. Again, same competition is starting in the government tender also. So I thought that in Singapore, you know, there is a one computer superstore. Still, they have a one superstore in Singapore. It's called Challenger. So suddenly I saw that one of the big superstores, you know, in Lower Plaza, you saw the IT hypermarket, right? IT hypermarket and a lot of the other superstores also in the Malaysia. So what happened? I thought that if I establish a one superstore, then people will come to my superstore and they will buy cash money. So there should not be any competition. So what happened? It came to my mind. I started to design my superstore. I invested a lot of money. In Bangladeshi Taka, in 1995, I invested 4.5 million Taka only for decoration. So after decoration, I lost all of my money. I don't have enough money, cash money, I finished. But you see, I did not finish my spirit. What happened? My decoration was beautiful. So I invited to the Lord of the supplier, can you visit me and see that what superstore I developed? So a lot of people give me the credit facility. Oh, your superstore is good. I have a lot of product in my store, so I give it to you. So I keep all of the product in my superstore. Within very few months, I become very successful because my cash flow is unbelievably good. In one day, in that time, 1995, my cash flow was 2 million plus. It's a huge money in that time. So what happened? 1996, again, I thought that, okay, only the computer superstore will not give the confidence of the people. So I again changed my business style. I went to the HP, I went to the Intel, I went to the Microsoft, Dell, lot of the big company. So I become the distributor of that company. So what happened? I bring the their product in my company and I sell with the branded product. All of the brand product, people know that all of the brand product will be available in the Daffodil Computer Showroom. So I can attract lot of people. So again I saw lot of other people is also, they are also become the dealer of HP, Compaq, Microsoft, Intel, because Intel is appointed three distributors. HP is appointed three distributors. So I thought, again, I'll fight with a lot of other people. So what should I do? I should do something exceptional than other competitors. Then 1997, I established DIIT, Daffodil Institute of IT, and I also affiliated with NCC UK. And again, in that year, I also think that my company should be the registered, joint stock registered company as a limited company. So 1997, I moved to the one track to the another track. I thought that in the near future, if I develop the educational system, so that is the one of the reason you students are here, and that is one of the reason I am also here. If I cannot establish in 1997 DIIT, I cannot establish Daffodil International University in 2001 or 2002. So that means I took the right decision in 1997. When there is a huge competition, I am not feel sleepy. I am not thinking myself I am failure. Rather, I took the challenge, move forward, try to establish another company. And then 1998, I formed a lot of company. I formed the various branch in the Silet, Khulna, a lot of other division. And I also try to bring a lot of other computer products from the various countries like Taiwan, Singapore. And I also become the partner of India Micro South Asia. So I just try to expand my business ability day by day. But again, in 1999, I understood the fighting is going high. A lot of people are coming to computer business. So my profit margin is going low. So what I should do? Then I introduced my own brand, Daffodil PC. In 1999, I established the Daffodil PC as a local, first local brand ISO 9002 certified. But again, I find this competition. Because as a local brand PC, people don't like to buy local products. They like to buy Japanese product, USA product, UK product. They don't like the local product. So what I did is, I'm just keeping continue on my local brand PC. At the same time, I am already trying to operate some other company. I am starting another new venture. It's called jobsbuddy.com. And maybe Malaysia, you know, jobstreet.com. So the jobstreet.com become the partner of jobsbuddy.com in 2005. So if I did not establish jobsbuddy in 2000, jobs still will not come to Bangladesh. So that's why I should take the right decision in 2000 to establish jobme.com. And I also started Operation ISP company, Web and e-commerce company. And also, I just started the DIIT, my educational operation in Chittagong and other district. And this year also become the GIS, started to selling the GIS product. That is, I'm trying to enhance my business opportunity slowly, slowly. And again, what happened? 2001, again, I started the Daffodil Software Limited. Because you know that 2001, earlier people was worried about computer. They don't bother about software. What happened? Now you see, the smartphone is not important. Important is your data. Important is your apps, right? But once upon a time, smartphone was important. Data was not important. So think same way, earlier, computer was important, hardware. But later on, computer is not important. Software is become important. So I started a new company, Daffodil Software Limited, Daffodil Multimedia. And also I'm just first digital magazine, first Bangladesh digital magazine we just started. And also in 2002-2003, I become the president of Bangladesh, largest computer association, which is the pioneer association of the IT industry. So that means gradually what happened? I face problem, I just change another track. I face problem, I change another track. Now 2002, as I already mentioned, I established the university. 2001, we applied for the university, and 2002, we got the affiliation of the Bangladesh government or the University Grants Commission as a university status. So what happened? 2003, we established other college. 2004, we established also various institutes like Dipti, My Kids, Daffodil Grameen IT Education. 2005, we also established another institution is called the Bangladesh Skill Development Initiative. 2006, we did a lot of the joint venture, as I mentioned, the jobstreet.com and Malaysian job portal and Malaysian other companies also did jointly with some activities with Malaysian various companies. And 2007, we just collaboration with another Malaysian company called BrightSoft and started another school. First, we started our school operation. 2008, we buy another IT company, a big IT company in Bangladesh, it's called the Dolphin Company. So what happened? 2009, we have started the chain school. 2010, we also enhanced our activities in other districts. 2011, you see that a lot of success is coming. Bangladesh, we also joined in the Asian University President Forum. 2012, we have also a lot of success, as I already mentioned earlier, because I was also engaged in the, some of the activities, so I become the President of Dhaka Chamber, the Pioneer Chamber of Commerce in Bangladesh. So 2013, I think, there is a lot of companies also we initiated, and I also wrote one book. And the first time I tried to become a writer, because on my own experience, I just launched my first book in 2013. And 2014, and we have a lot of other initiatives, first business incubator. As you know, that I personally try to see all of you as an entrepreneur. If you try to make yourself as an entrepreneur, you can create a lot of jobs for the other people. But if you try to find a job, you can become a servant to the other people. I'm so sorry. I don't like to undermine to the servant. But please think first to become a job provider, rather job seeker. And then you see, between this time, I'm sure that we established this Daffodil. Lot of venture, I don't like to go to the all, because lot of venture we already established during this time. So what I was a failure. When I started, I was failure. I face a lot of problems, but if I am sleeping, if I am frustrating, if I am blaming to Allah, do you think Allah will give me the benefit? No. So I hope that you understand. I'm sure you are thinking yourself to become an entrepreneur. Think yourself to become an entrepreneur. Pray to Allah to become an entrepreneur. Work always to become an entrepreneur. Of course, Allah will give you the spirit, opportunity, everything. Now I give you one example. Say suppose one of the building is six-storied building. It do not have any lift. So this six-storied building, you try to go up with the stair, with stairs. Now tell me, if you are an entrepreneur,
what you will do it. If you entrepreneur, if you know there is opportunity in the sixth floor, you don't worry about to leap to other opportunity. You will climb up and go to the destination and try to find out the opportunity. But think yourself, you physically not fit in that day. But your spirit is okay. Your spirit is okay, but physically you are weak. You do not have enough speed to going up. So what you will do it? Maybe one step, two step, three step. In four step, you thought, no, I don't have spirit. I'm physically weak. But mentally you are okay to going up in the sixth floor. What will happen? Maybe fourth step, you are sitting down. So what happened? Some of your friend may be coming to going up. So then he can ask you, hey friend, what happened? Friend, I'm physically not fit. I have also friend who going up. So that's why I'm taking rest. So your friend will help you. Come, catch my hand, I'll help you. So maybe fifth step, sixth step, ninth step, eighth step, you're going up. Maybe your friend is also trying to help you. But what will happen? Maybe next another friend will be coming who is physically fit. Hey, why you are? No, you see, I'm physically unfit, but I'm just coming to the fourth step. Then my another friend is helping me to the second story, but now I cannot. Maybe this friend will be quite enough strength. He can pull you. And he can pull you, and maybe he can going up to the sixth floor, right? So that means, what is your intention? Your intention to reach to the destination, right? It doesn't matter you are physically weak. It does not matter you have the ability to going up. But your intention was to going up, that's why you are climbing, and fourth step you are waiting, and after two stories you are waiting. But think yourself, if you, as a weak person, if you are not going to one step, two step, you are sitting to the down to the stair. So other people will coming and they will open their money bag and they'll give you the money. They understood you are a beggar. Am I right? Am I right or wrong? Because when other people will be coming and they will see that you are sitting, they will thought maybe you are a beggar. They never thought you are an entrepreneur. Because entrepreneur need to be step up in one, two, three, at least he or she should try. If you try, that's why fourth step another people ask you, hey, what happened? Why you are sitting here? But if you step down in the down step, then other people will think that you are a beggar. You are asking money. So, are you thinking you are an entrepreneur?
Yes.
Thank you very much. I hope that you will. That means what message I give it to you? You need to start. You need to start. So, entrepreneur always think forward. Entrepreneur never think backward. Entrepreneur is always positive. So, entrepreneur, what happened? Entrepreneur is always positive. And I think the start, but as I already give this slide, start. Entrepreneur always need to start. You see, he don't bother, he has a tie, he has a shoes. He thought, no. To start the running, I need to go back my home. I have to wear my sportswear, then I'll come and I'll start. So between this time, other people will run, compete, and they will become the champion. So entrepreneur is always waiting for the opportunity. You don't know why I am telling you, please go to the various shopping mall, try to find out the opportunity. Maybe a lot of opportunities waiting you. But if you think, no, now I am student. After completion my education, I will see that what opportunity is waiting for me. No. You don't know when opportunity will come to you. So you need to prepare yourself every time. Whenever referee will give the bashi, will just whistle, you need to start. You need to start. So I hope that you just entrepreneur, you always need to be positive and always think the critical and creative thinking. And as a entrepreneur, few minutes back, you know, your provision seller, what he mentioned, entrepreneur need a good mentor, right? Say, student of the home, you join here. Why? Because hope and husband is pushing you to come here. But it is wrong. Don't think me misunderstand. Why husband, why hope will push you? Rather, you will push hope. Am I right? Lot of students will push hope. We like to become an entrepreneur. We just got information, global entrepreneurship summer camp will be happening. Please enroll us. Please enroll us. I think Asmar will be tired. Thousand students coming to joining this global entrepreneurship summer camp. But no. That means what happened? You see, Allah always giving you the opportunity as you like to make yourself. I'm sure if I think myself to become a servant, to get a job, Allah will give me a good job maybe. But I am lucky enough, thanks to Almighty, I determine myself I like to become an entrepreneur. And that is one of the reasons a lot of thousand people I'm able to provide them job opportunity. So that's why I must say that as you provide sincere, as is already mentioned, you need a good mentor. But I tell you, you don't need a good mentor now. Why? Is there anyone can say? You don't need a good mentor now. Why? Can anyone say why?
I'm the mentor.
Because the Google uncle is with you. So your uncle is a very good mentor. Whatever you ask to your uncle will give it to you. You see, as I mentioned in my opening speech, I do not know what is called Casablanca. So I asked them, Filipino, what is called Casablanca? They did not explain me clearly. But suddenly it came to my mind. I have Google uncle, why am I asking them? So I am just asking the Google, hey uncle, what is Casablanca? Uncle, show me this picture. So I know it's very good available in Bangladesh. So that's why your mentor is always with you. You don't feel shy. Your mentor is always with you to give the lesson. If you face any sorts of problem, say the Malaysian people, you do not know Bangla, it doesn't matter. The Google translator is with you. You see, the Bangladeshi people, you don't know Malay, it doesn't matter. You type in Bengali, you ask your same thing to the Malaysian friend. So by this way, you can learn each other and you can make a good networking, it doesn't matter. So technology is also with you. A good mentor is always with you, but you are not utilizing your strength properly. So this is, I think, as already mentioned, that your goal setting. You need to set your goal. What is your goal? Is it your goal to become an entrepreneur? If your goal is entrepreneur, then you don't feel sleepy. Night times, whenever you're going to bed, you also think that what should be your next day planning? What you learn today? And keep the note besides your pillow. Because suddenly it came to your mind that, oh, this idea is good. Or maybe you can forget to keep record one of your friend. But suddenly it came to your mind. You write it down, oh, I met with Mr. Azman of the Hope in UC. So what happened? Next day, whenever you're meeting, you can make handshake with Azman. I'm so sorry, I forget to take your card, visiting card. Can you help me? So if you don't write it down, then you cannot keep it in your memory. Next day, you cannot recall that what idea is came to your mind. So always you have to utilize the opportunity. Always you have to focus your goal. What is your goal? His goal is entrepreneur. What type of entrepreneur? There is a plenty of entrepreneurship. What type of entrepreneurship you are planning? Think yourself, where you are strong, where you are strong. You see, there is a lot of kinds of entrepreneurship. If you can do any business, you can also become an entrepreneur. How? If you are a good speaker, that's also one good entrepreneur. You can sell your video to the YouTube. Am I right? If you are not a good speaker, but you can use the technology, social networking, or you know the art of technology. So you are not a good speaker, you do not have money, but you know how to use the technology. So by using the technology, you can also become a good entrepreneur. By how? Because you can promote some of their activities, some of their video. You know how to make link, share, you can promote SEO, and you can make such a fantastic tools that the other businessmen come to you and help you and give you the opportunity. Hey man, help me. Hey woman, help me. I'm just promote my business, my brand, my product. So can you help me? So you can help them to promote their product through the online activity. But if you just chatting and sharing with your social networking friend, giving the selfie and status, but it's not work. You need to think yourself that how you can utilize your opportunity in every day, every time. Because you have plenty of opportunity. If you set your goal, you need to set your goal. You need to use your technology. Because why God is already giving the technology? Because Allah knows this millennium baby. You are all of the millennium baby. This millennium.